Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Renzo. Today I'm going to paint this beautiful image. I found this image in pixel.com. You can find in the description of the video. You're going to find the link to this image. We're going to start with the colors. Titanium white, lemon yellow, cadmium red, alizarin crimson, cerulean blue, ultramarine blue, and ivory black. My brushes are synthetics. I have flat, filter, and round. Okay, I'm gonna start this, making a drawing with this pit pastel. Okay, first, let me show you the image close, and you can see how beautiful it is. If you see the image in the description, you're gonna see that it's like, has more here. I just cut the image because to make it just fit here. Okay, I'm gonna start with the drawing. First, I see the overall shape here. And let's see what the place here around here. Okay. I'm making this negative space, this triangle here. Now, let's say I'm making a circle here, or a square. Now, a rectangle here. Okay, from here, I'm gonna make a little, I'm gonna draw some details on the face. These lines are for the proportion of the face. I'm squinting my eyes and trying to see the difference between light and shadows. Just placing the position of the eyes, nose, and mouth. Okay. I think that would be enough. Now, my palette. For a painting that it has so many colors, when I paint, of course, I paint with a separated palette. But now, of course, I'm using the canvas as a palette in order for you to see all the mixtures that I'm going to make here. I'm going to separate my palette. This portion is going to be for the skin colors. This portion for the t-shirt. Okay. Here I can make for a mixture for the apron, and this portion is going to be just for the background. Okay, if you have seen my other videos, you know that I start always with a simple orange color for the skin. I have just an orange color, and I going to grade down this color with white and ivory black. Okay. This color is going to be for the lights. I repeat again. Cadmium yellow, cadmium red, white, and black. added too much black. Something like this happened to you? Just, I mean, add more yellow and red again, and more white again. Okay, this color is going to be flat shadows. Okay. Now, from her t-shirt, can mix that pink. Okay. I'm going to add a little bit of blue to gray down the color. I prefer not to go directly to the color exactly, okay? I prefer to, let's say, saturate the color, but by applying more paint on top of the first layer. I mean, every time my mixture is gonna be like more pure, more saturated, but this first layer is gonna be more mute. Now for the shadow. And I don't use too much paint at the beginning, okay? Because I'm not so sure about the colors and all of that yet. As soon as I'm going to be sure about the colors, I'm gonna start applying more thick paint. Okay, now, okay, let's start with that. I'm going to use linseed oil and turpentine in a 50-50 ratio. I'm just trying to paint the shape of the light. I'm not thinking right now about the eyes, the mouth, or the nose. Okay, now, and use different brushes. That's gonna be really good. At the end, if you just a couple of brushes, what is going to happen is you have to clean out the brushes again and again all the time. I mean, for me, that's wasting time, and sometimes we cannot clean out any brush just perfectly. And at the end, we're starting to pollute all the mixtures. With this color, I'm going to draw the eyes, nose, and mouth. Don't worry about if the color is not okay now. We're gonna work on the color layer by layer. I'm gonna bring more of this. Cadmium yellow, cadmium red, black, and white. Take your time for mixing the colors. Just be sure just to gray down these colors. And then in a little bit of solvent. It's not. Going to mix more here. Remember, it's always an orange, and you tone down the orange, or bring down the orange, adding white and black. You can add white and blue if you prefer. It's up to you. I mean, some people just prefer not to use black. That's okay. For me, I prefer to use black because black is gray down any color so fast. And because I usually paint a la prima, I mean, I'm gonna think in fastest ways to save time. Yeah? Okay. I'm going to separate these two brushes. Then I'm going to use the next two ones for the t-shirt. Okay. And adding more solvent. I'm squinting my eyes all the time. Because at the same time that I'm painting, I'm drawing. Okay. I'll be back to this color. Let's mix here a color for the apron. And adding solvent. Now in this part of my palette, I'm not going to mix any of the colors for the background. think. Okay. I will go first with the light, the lightest colors. I'm just keeping this because I gotta go back. Yes. And that's why I always encourage just to keep an order on the palette. That's really important. It really pay off at the end. Move the image. Remember, you have the link to the image in the description of the video. If you see the image, You're gonna see that I'm going to need a thin all this space. Now let's go back to the face. I'm gonna use these two brushes, number zero, liner brushes. One is going to be for a darker color, and the other one is gonna be for a lighter color. I use these two brushes like they were pencils. I just love to think in this way. And I have a lighter color and a darker color. I'm going to draw the face with this brush. I'm going to put the image here. I have the image in my computer. This way I can see it very clearly. I'm just keeping the small image to see the overall shape of everything and for you to see, I mean, how I am copying this. Adding a little bit of solvent. We have to change to a smaller brush. I'm going to use this one. Let me see if it works okay. Number two. I haven't used it before, it's completely new. Let's see if it works okay. Brush is number 00. Thank you. Okay, I'm going to continue with the arms and the hands. And then I'll be back later to the face. Okay. Oh, the t-shirt. Yes, was forgetting this. Thank you. Thank you, Mayu and TS. Thank you. sorry for all the noise. I don't know if you hear those people sitting on the street, because I live downtown, and here there's, I'm not able to see on my studio like properly because of the smell, I use trumpet time for cleaning my brushes. And if I close my studio, trying not letting any sound just come inside my studio, that would be impossible for me to breathe here. That's why in my videos, you always gonna hear my neighbors, people sitting on the street, maybe my son, my daughter, my dog. Okay, I'm going to start adding more contrast. Let me add black to the hair, black and a touch of a different crimson. Oh, Nick, sorry, maybe, I'm saying medium and solvent, for me it's the same thing. Sorry if I say sometimes solvent or medium. I just have linseed oil and turpentine. That's what I use. I use that at the beginning usually. And right now I'm not using more solvent because I just want to apply more thick paint. Because right now I'm checking the drawing and I feel that it's okay. I feel more secure about going with more paint. I'm going to take out the image. You have the image in the description. It's from this website, pexels.com. That means that you can use it. You can print out the image and paint with that. Okay. I'm just going to keep it just down here. I'm copying the image because, I mean, when I saw this picture, this photo, I just liked it, yes. And I knew that it was, I was about to paint it. I knew that I needed to paint this picture. The only thing I'm going to change is this and adding more shadow here, more darker color here. Because if you see the image, there's a blue light, a light blue light here. And you get confused with the skin color. Just changing that just to give more attention to the face. And adding solvent. Or medium. I'm painting on canvas. Okay, and cheap canvas, you're asking me if cheap canvases are really that bad? To be honest, yes. I mean, sometimes maybe more than once I just bought some cheapest canvases. That was terrible. It's impossible to paint on that. The only thing I had to do at the time, I was applied a layer of gesso, a couple of coat of gesso, because that was impossible to use those canvases. Okay, now going back to the face. These are all the brushes that I'm using right now. I'm gonna put it back here. This way you can see. I'm going to add a little bit more colors to the face. The nose, it has to be always reddish. a little bit reddish or orangey. And the cheeks. Angela. Okay, thank you, Angela. Tea is one cup, guests only. Yes, I mean, when I bought these cheap canvases, remember I applied one coat of queso. Yeah, it was okay. I mean, it already has queso, but it's not enough. I mean, just because it, I mean, this canvas is just soak all the oil. That's impossible just to move the brush on top of the canvas. Nick, is it possible to glaze a portrait with just linseed oil, or do I have to use glazing medium? To be honest, I mean, there are so many products I have heard that what's the name of this? I don't remember. Liquin. There's some liquin that a friend of mine told me that is really good. To be honest, I prefer just to use linseed oil and turpentine. I mean, that's the only thing I use. I usually mix both of them 50-50. And I use that all the time. I haven't tried anything more. I just have heard that. But, I mean, I feel like I don't need to try anything more, that I'm okay with what I do with the materials I have. But to be honest, I feel that I should try more, maybe more new materials, but I don't know. Maybe I feel too old just to try anything more. I got stuck with this. Linseed oil and turpentine. I don't use the odorless turpentine. I use the one that smells so bad. I don't know what happened. I think I love the smell. I feel like that's turpentine. I bought once this odorless one, and I felt like I wasn't using the real turpentine. I mean, if I should advise, or if I should recommend, I would recommend the odorless one because the smell is so bad. Nix, your normal use white spirit and underpainting as it dulls the paint down and dries quickly. If you have seen those results, maybe you try to mix them, Yeah. I mean, I haven't tried that. I always use turpentine and linseed oil. Sometimes, I'm thinking when I'm about to painting, applying so many layers, and then you dry, and then another layer. Usually, the first layer is really thin, and it's very liquid, and then I use more turpentine than linseed oil. But I never use turpentine alone. Just by itself, never mind. I always mix it with linseed oil. For me, it's because it feels like watercolor sometimes because it's too liquid, and I don't like that consistency. Okay, now we're going to paint the hands. you can see these colors are for the hair, the skin, this color for the t-shirt, and on this portion of the palette is just for all these colors around here. It's difficult to keep an order in the palette, but I tried really so hard just to keep an order of the mixtures, the color. Sometimes I separate the mixture by temperature, warm and cool colors. And usually I separate the mixtures by light and dark colors. I'm watching a bigger image. I'm watching this image just to let you know, because I mean that's kind of impossible to see these details, and having this image here just for you to see the process. But I have a bigger image. I mean, I have the image in my computer, on my screen, and I can zoom in and see details. Like I told you, the image is in the description of the video. You can download it, and you can see that this really a high resolution, and this image is for pixels. That code is copyrighted free. That means that you can print out, paint it, and okay, interesting. Steve, do you use only Winton oil paints? Yes, I'm using Winton. I haven't tried this water mixable oils. I haven't tried that thing. It's here that, I mean, seems like they are almost like regular oil paints. Thank you. I'm just trying to warm up the slide a little bit. I love this yellow light, just like the sun or the sunset was hitting. If you see the image, you can see that this light is a cool light because it's coming. When this is coming from the sky, usually it's like a blue light, a light blue light. When it's directly from the sun, it's a warm light. But we can change that, yes. We can, try to change that, try to see if it works okay or not. And if it doesn't work, we just put it back to where it was. Let me try just to warm up all the lights. A little bit. The only problem that is that I have to do that everywhere. When you change the light, you have to change it everywhere. Even here. This is pink, but anyway, that's, you gotta put yellow on top of this. On the hand too. Give it here. Mixing both cadmium yellow and lemon yellow. Now, in order to see this, let's say more stronger, I'm gonna go with some violet, some purple. to erase this because the painting is not in that here.
Thank you.
Oh, hello, Nidhi. Okay. Oh, the size is like, can you see my hand? It's like 7 inches by 12. That would be maybe 25 centimeters by 35. This is a really small painting because, I mean, the idea is just trying to finish the painting in 3 hours. And the other reason that I prefer to paint small is because it's the way that I have placed my webcam. That's the only way that if I paint bigger, I gotta move the webcam. And that would be possible for me just to have this position. I should be painting just the same with an angle. In this way, it could be a distortion when you see the image. This is the only way that the camera doesn't bother me too much. Okay, I'll go back to the background. Thank you. Okay, I think that's it. Mm-hmm. Yes. Let me hear a little bit of yellow. Okay. Thank you so much for being here with me, watching the video. I hope you enjoyed this demonstration. I'm going to wait for this painting to dry, and I'm going to place some places this. Because I love the painting. I mean, I love this image, the reference. Okay? That's why I think it needs more work. I can make it better. But I gotta let it dry. And then I'll apply some glazes. Okay. I'm not missing anything important. I think everything is okay. Okay. Thank you so much. See you next time. Bye. Take care.